Hi, I'm Laura Kelly from Poca Cape Cod TV. Today we're in Harwich. We're actually at the town hall, and NSTAR has been spraying herbicides along power lines, and there's a lot of uproar about this right now. Unfortunately, they've been spraying near animals, near feed, outside of their actual bounds, perhaps on private property. We don't know for sure, but what we're hearing is it's they're spraying when it's over 15 mile an hour winds, and that's
I'm Andrew Slackman and the town of Harwich. I stand to talk about a matter that has been brought to me by the Fourth Estate. In the Chatham, the Cape Cod Chronicle, NSTAR spraying strays out of bounds, residents say. Harwich. Residents in North Harwich are upset with the actions of a company hired by NSTAR to implement an integrated vegetative management plan to control trees and brush under the power lines. They say widespread spraying of herbicides were done well outside the boundaries defined by the plan, and no precaution was taken in the resource area of Smelt Creek or near Seahorse Farm, where grazing horses, they say, were missed with chemical spray. Get the details online at the Chatham Chronicle. So I read that today. I became upset about it because, you know, Maud DeVictor, a VA office worker in Chicago, found out about Agent Orange, and she wasn't a scientist. She saw a lot of veterans showing up with 2,4-5-T dioxin poisoning. It was some woman who stood and said, we have to look into this. Joel Feigenbaum in Sandwich challenged the base operations of spilling toxic fuel on our single source aquifer. NSTAR, our utility company that we pay to deliver our power, is now delivering the power of chemical poisons in town, in Harwich. I would like to find out what the Department of Public Health, who, if a fish doesn't have a right temperature, shuts somebody down, what are we going to do about NSTAR or NSTAR's providers that are contracted out to spray? I then called Carol Berg, who is the owner of Seahorse Farm, and I encouraged her to come. So my introduction is to introduce Carol Berg to tell you in person what she saw with her own eyes, and I urge the Board of Selectmen to make sure that we think about having a meeting 2 weeks from now. We will fill this room with concerned citizens, but we have to act. NSTAR, say no to spray. Nay to spray.
Yeah, I've been working on this NSTAR issue, bringing education to both MDAR, Massachusetts Department of Agricultural Resources, and NSTAR, as well as town, Cape residents, abutters, and beyond. Claire is here, a person who, you know, they sprayed her horse farm, and she has actual physical, lesions.
But again, I'd rather, since it's not a debatable subject, to,
could you put it on your agenda for 2 weeks?
We can put it on the agenda, but I'm not going to,
What we need is we're here because we need your help. We know that we've done a lot on this topic. Thank you guys last year for writing your own resolution and signing against NSTAR spraying in your town. That was very helpful to a degree. Obviously, it didn't stop anything, getting all 14 towns to do the same thing. What we're asking is for your town to get even more involved. Obviously, there are many townspeople there. You know, you've been getting comments from your health department, and it's time to listen to them speaking to you. Can you get your lawyers involved? This is what our ask is of you. We need to go the next move. We've done everything we possibly can, so we thank you for your help.
Okay, and we can add it to the agenda in a couple weeks, but we're not going to debate it tonight because
don't even debate it tonight. I appreciate your time, and if anybody back home would like to rally, we're going to be going outside of NSTAR October 29th at noon. Thank you very much.
These people sprayed them right on my property line. They were within 20 feet of my horses, and they weren't spraying the ground, they were spraying straight out. And 15 mile per hour winds were blowing this chemical into my horse farm. Okay, that put my horses in danger, it put me in danger. I instantly got a migraine. I have a rash all over my torso from the chemicals. My body reacts to chemicals very badly, and the rash is still there. The doctors want to put me on steroids to get rid of them, and I can't. I can't do chemicals. So that's what they did to my horses and to myself and to my boarder's horses. You've got to do something. Please,
Bobby McDonald, and I'm a member of Green Cape, and we have been working on this problem as well. And last year I was able to get a chart from NSTAR, and that's the total amount that they sprayed last year. We have been asking for a schedule where they will be, what day, what time, so that people have a chance of protecting themselves from the spray. NSTAR won't say where they sprayed or when they sprayed, because sometimes they spray when the wind gusts are far more than will protect anyone from wind drift. Also rainy conditions. So I think every town and every person that's going to be affected needs to find out exactly when and where NSTAR is going to be so they can stop them. It's very unfortunate what happened at the horse farm, but it's unfortunately not unusual.
It was just a matter of time, perhaps. You know, they're going pretty much, you know, straight down the power lines. I also heard this evening here at the town hall that they went through some wetlands straight through without changing their amounts of chemicals or even chemical types of herbicides in the wetland areas. So there's a lot of buzz happening, and we're doing our best to bring it up to the State House and to continue the conversation and discussion. There's somebody else here, Claire, who is from the horse farm that was sprayed recently. So would you introduce yourself?
I'm Claire Burke from Seahorse Farm in Harwich. On Tuesday morning, NSTAR's crew came through and sprayed chemicals right in front of my horse farm. There were 15 mile per hour winds, and they had backpack blowers, not sprayers, but blowers.
Yeah, they're 4 inches.
4-inch hoses, and they big, huge machines, and they had their hands out like this, spraying 8 abreast down the power lines.
Wow.
The chemicals were in a fog going sideways across my farm. It was disgusting.
So yeah.
Okay, so White's Pond is here, so we're right in here. So they sprayed for probably 15, 20 minutes.
Wow.
And
Walking eight abreast,
they were right along my property line. My horses are 20 feet from the property line on the upper barn.
Did they have masks on or
they
gloves?
No masks, they had gloves. Some had goggles, but other than that, nothing. No protection for themselves. One guy had no teeth. So I don't know if he's been doing this for a while or not, but it was,
And what did it do to you?
I have developed a rash Tuesday afternoon, and I have it. It's still on my torso. It's on my arms, on my neck. Hasn't gone to my legs yet, but that could be happening. But each day it gets worse.
Wow. Is it a burning? What's the sensation?
It doesn't itch. It's just a rash, it covers. You know, there's some red spots, but mostly you can't see it, but you can feel the bumps.
Heated temperature?
Nope. No itch, no nothing. I did get a migraine from the chemicals that they sprayed. I use everything is hypoallergenic, fragrance free. I can't do anything that has a scent. So anything that is scented like that gives me a migraine. But the lower barn, the property line, is where the horses are. So they were right there getting full run.
Because you have paddocks
run.
Outside, right? And they get fed out there.
They get fed outside. They live outside.
And the water out there.
Yep. So they had to have the water changed. They had to get hosed off from tip to toe to just to get the chemicals off their bodies because it was so bad. But the after effect was the smell.
Yes.
It lingered all afternoon. It didn't go away.
Oh.
So I can't imagine what the chemical was they sprayed, but
it's a combination.
My body's not happy, I know that much.
Cryonite emulsifier with a petroleum base surfactant, and it's a combination. They're doing actual woody applications right now, not foliar. So they're doing like the pine trees, the oak trees, you know, anything that's going to grow over 15 feet tall. They'll leave the scrub oaks, but that's it.
And you happen to say that you're, it's Lynch Road.
Mark Lynch.
He actually did cutting.
He and his wife Kelly do all the cutting in front of their property. So they're at the scrub pines right now are only about this tall. And the rest of the stuff is basically just native, you know, plants
vegetation.
Like wild cranberries and stuff and yes. bear berries and stuff like
so they
that.
They were spraying that.
They were spraying that. And there's mostly grass there.
So that's not just the horses, it's the birds, it's the whole system.
The wildlife.
It's the whole ecosystem.
Right.
So we're glad that you're here to tell us this because we're not taking this lightly. If it wasn't for people like you, we wouldn't get this. So we're very grateful.
Well, isn't that interesting?
In an unfortunate way, yes.
They're spraying the ground cover, which actually defeats the purpose.
Right.
The whole purpose of the vegetation management plan is to only kill back things that grow over 15 feet tall. Killing back the native vegetation like the cranberries and the blueberries and such,
yep.
That's actually, you know, well, technically it's illegal. They're
not
supposed to. And drift is taken under some sort of consideration, but not 15
Well, you know, they say it was supposed to be a week to a week and a half to see some results, okay? Mm-hmm. It's a week tomorrow morning.
Did you get notification?
No notification from anybody.
And they didn't tell you they were coming, of course.
I smelled them before I knew they were coming.
Oh.
And I saw this four-wheeler driving back and forth on
yeah.
the power lines. I'm like, what are they doing? What are they doing?
So
and all of a sudden...
Of what? Chemicals.
On the back
of the four-wheeler, that's right.
Little, so if,
they have
if your horses are harmed, if
you're... actual 3 to 5 gallon amounts of herbicides in these containers that they cannot mix or actually pour on the power lines. So they have them already set out in the back of an ATG or C or whatever they're called, a four-wheeler.
ATV,
yep. And they have gasoline in the back of this ATV because these are gas-powered, four-inch wide, not sprayers, but blowers. And with the 3 to 5 gallon pack behind them, they just spray until they need another one and it gets, you know, given to them by... So did you see any sort of anybody monitoring the situation? So there should be somebody there with like a GPS stating, look, animals, stay 50 feet away.
Nope.
Or, hey, there's some water, there's a wetland, there's, you know,
There was a guy that was operating ATV.
Yeah.
And the eight guys with the backpacks burned.
And that's it.
Blowers. That was it. Nobody else.
Any idea where the truck was that they came in from?
They probably used the old Harwich Brewster Road to come in on.
Yeah.
And they might have been parked down the bottom of the hill.
Right.
I didn't go down there to look because, you know, it was just... Need to get out of there.
Yeah, I have other people that were there that day.
One of my boarders was there.
Yeah.
I had to leave for an appointment for about an hour and a half. She was there while this spraying was going on in the lower barn. And she was standing about 60 feet away from the property line because she couldn't
take
the chemicals.
Could they see you? Could they see that there were
I walked right over to where the ATV was. I said, I need to know what you're spraying. These
Which
are my
is
animals.
Actually, a person should be 100 feet. They cannot be 100 feet in front.
It won't harm your horses.
Yeah. And I say that...
That's the sad thing, that they truly believe it's harmless.
Well,
and
you know,
that's true.
It could be. It very well could be.
But it isn't.
My suggestion is that you reach
right
out, as we said earlier, with Marina Cesar, the
Marina Cesar,
the vet, and ask her to watch the horses and or to investigate and find
they
out.
They won't be coming through again. I'll give you that much. At this point, this year, now.
I don't know.
They can only do spot treatments within the next year. But considering nothing is of harm to our electrical source, they're not going to be coming back to the town. That much I can say pretty guaranteedly. They're not allowed to spray it another time. They're allowed to spot treat. Totally different. They can't pack
back. There's nothing to spot treat out there.
So you felt, as you said earlier, you felt like if... You know, if you're armed and dangerous, you could have stopped it because they were harming your wildlife.
They were putting my animals in danger, yes. I mean, my animals eat natural food.
Of course.
I don't give them chemicals. I don't put chemicals in their body. Like, I don't eat chemicals. I'm not going to give them chemicals.
Yes.
So that was very harmful to them. And I monitor them every day, make sure, you know, taking their temperature, making sure they're okay. If I see any signs of anything out of the ordinary. You know,
well,
can I ask you one quick question?
Yeah.
Were you 100 feet away or closer to the spraying?
Oh, they were much closer.
You in person. You walked over to them too, but they stopped.
They weren't spraying at that point because my neighbor walked over to him at the same time. And there was one guy near my property line. I walked over and I asked him what they were spraying. And he said, it's not important for you to know. It won't harm your horses.
And you didn't
and
get
I'm
any?
Like, it won't harm my horses, but I've got a migraine. So it's harming me. So I need to know what you're spraying. You don't need to know.
It's not fair for them to belittle another human in the well, you know, procedure, too.
They were hired by NSTAR, so maybe they were sworn to secrecy. Yeah, you tell them what you were spraying, we'll fire you or something. Who knows, but...
They didn't put anything on your doorknob?
No notification whatsoever. None. I got notification from NSTAR, who was replacing the wires and the poles.
Yes.
That guy came to my farm and we talked and he said, this is what's going to be happening. Just want to let you know for your horses, if you have to put horses in, if they're scared of the wires and stuff. Nothing about spraying.
So for anybody back home, if they want to come and help us rally, we'll be outside of the headquarters of NSTAR, location off of Exit 7 on October 29th, right before Halloween.
Right.
So come and join us, and anybody else that feels that they have something, a message, a point, a fact, a comment, any sort of concern, whether it's emotional or fact-based, please get in touch with POCA, pocacapecod.org, or at gmail.com. We're looking for comments now, and we're going to do something about it.